Hello, Bulldogs. My name is Oscar Granados.
And I'm Amanda Sardinas. Today is May 20th, 2020.
Teachers all around the world have been trying their hardest to make their students feel comfortable during this virtual transition.
Even on hard days when all hope is lost, they have made their students feel appreciated and motivated to keep going.
We here at Braddock TV took it upon ourselves to show our appreciation to all of the teachers who have made our senior year the most memorable one.
You, Mr. Ray, for
making our
senior
year
the
year.
Cat cameo. I love it. You guys are cute.
We tried.
Yeah, we did. You guys still don't understand what that means, man. Thank you. Hey, that's not BS, man. I take it. That's deep. Thank you very much. You're taking the time for that.
Thank you. Thank you for joining us. I mean,
thank you.
So happy we got to talk to you.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. I wish you the best.
Thank you, guys. I love you guys so much. And I miss you. And thank you for taking this moment to do that. And it means a lot to me. And when this thing is controlled, we're going to have a prom in my yard. That's all I'm saying. We're going to.
During these unprecedented times, we all need a little song to cheer us up.
The seniors of 2020 have made sure to keep the party going with their quirky TikTok dances and funny challenges.
Here's Braddock's very own drama troupe performing a silly parody of the song When Will My Life Begin from the movie Tangled.
11 a.m. the usual morning lineup.
Stare at my phone and think about everything.
Log into Date School's laundry, Lysol, and shine up.
Sleep again, and by then it's like I should go eat.
So I'll read a book, or maybe two or three.
I'll burn up all my toast, cause I'm no foyardee.
I'll do crunches and sweat.
And cooking basically, just wonder when will Corona end.
Then after lunch is TikTok dances and streaming.
Virtual classes, Zooming with Coach JT.
Napping again and sleeping again and napping.
Then I'll stretch, maybe sketch, sanitize my jacket.
I'll play some video games, it's not like I have plans.
Take my dog for a walk, and then I'll wash my hands.
And I'll scroll through Instagram.
Stuck in the same place I've always been.
I'll keep wandering and wandering and wandering and wandering. And what will Corona end?
You may have seen the news a few weeks ago that the 2020 Tokyo Olympics were canceled.
Well, fear not, ladies and gentlemen. Our very own Kayla Mendez faces off against her brother Matthew in the first and only Mendez Quarantine Olympics. I wonder who's going to win.
You can't count it.
Oh, I got a 12.
Seconds. 3, 2, 1.
I don't know.
It's not gonna happen. There you go.
Come on, Kayla. The patient. He needs you. Oh, dude. This is sad times.
I got it.
Yo, are you? Tang.
I think most of us need a haircut, but we have no idea where or how to begin.
Well, let's go into the barbershop with our very own Brian Castaño as he gives us his breakdown of giving himself a well-deserved haircut.
What is up, guys, and welcome to the barbershop. I'm going to show you how to do haircuts in your own backyard. I know some of y'all haven't been going to the barbershop. Obviously, it's closed. Maybe your barbers aren't doing haircuts in their backyards. That's all right. I'm about to show you how to do it. Now, you see right here, you start on the front, start taking off some of them curls, you know. It's getting stuck. That kind of sucks. That's all right. We're going to keep going. I'm going to show you how to do it and how to do it just perfectly. So you see here, you get a little side angle. We're going to trim some of that from the top. Start from one side, start going all the way to the other side. I know you like it. Here's a little love for you. All right. So as we keep going, you know, brush some of that hair off. Keep going. Start on the other side. Start taking off. You know, try to make everything real even. Start on one size, you know, start on maybe like a 20 and then start going down the levels all the way down to 1, 0. A little bit of a front U for you. Kind of hard to work with. I got a lot of curls and tangles in my head. Don't worry about it. Just keep going. I know some of you got that luscious hair, so don't even worry about that. Just keep working on it. All right. Got a feel for the product. And we're back. So as y'all can see, I switched locations. Some of you may see a difference in my hair. Don't worry about that. Look how good it's coming out. Uh-huh. Alright, enough of the jokes, so here you go. Finished product. Yeah.
Our high school years will forever be engraved in our hearts. To our lowest of lows and our highest of highs, we will never forget the people that shaped us and the experiences we shared together.
No matter where we are in the future, we will always reminisce on the best years of our youth shared here at Braddock. Now here's a sweet senior video montage filled with moments we will always hold dearest to our hearts.
Due to the coronavirus outbreak, us seniors have had to spend our final moments stuck in quarantine.
So we here at BTV took it upon ourselves to ask some of our seniors how they're doing and what they miss most about high school.
Something that I miss the most about high school definitely has to be being able to spend the last year of my childhood or like my whole like educational life. Being able to spend that with my family and my friends and looking forward to graduation and grad bash and all that.
I think what I miss most about school would definitely be the extracurriculars that I got to enjoy with all my friends, like cheerleading and drama, because at those points, as I was a senior, I was already very comfortable in all of my teams, and it's just fun to be a senior when, you know, you're in cheerleading or drama or whatever you're in, and it's more exciting, and I just miss it a lot.
My favorite senior memory was senior pep rally because it was really rewarding to be able to see all of the hard work that we put into all of the routines for cheer, drama, the TikTok battle, like, come alive, and for the whole school to be able to see them.
My favorite senior memory was senior night during halftime when the rest of the team, like, had, like, little, like, posters for us and, like, we all took pictures as a team. Even though I think it was like raining.
I'd say my favorite senior memory is the TikTok dance battle at our senior pep rally. That was something that was super out of my comfort zone, and I would love to do it again.
My favorite senior memory was probably the senior brunch, because I think it embodied everything I loved about high school in one. You know, they played a great slideshow at the end where we like recounted all the memories that we had throughout high school. And some of my favorite teachers were there, and I was hanging out with my friends. and we did the senior skit, which I was a part of, so it was just a really fun time. It had everything I loved in it.
High school has prepped me for the future by teaching me how to be punctual since there's only 4 minutes between every class, and I have also learned how to manage my time. Since I am a Cambridge student, I have learned how to be productive and still get everything done.
High school has prepared me for the future by showing me that hard work and dedication really pays off.
I think high school has prepared me for life by trying to get me to do the impossible, like have a good social life, good sleeping schedule, 4.0, and a bunch of extracurriculars and a job, and try to make the best out of it that you can, which I think that's what life is all about.
Thank you for tuning in to our final episode. It's been a great year.
We hope you and your families are safe as we'll get through all of this together.
And remember to make it happen with Braddock TV.
Hey, class of 2020.
Seniors of 2020.
Hello, class of 2020.
Hi, my beautiful children. It's me, Miss Darna.
Hi, Braddock Bulldogs.
Hello, class of 2020.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You made it.
Hey, this is Carmenati saying goodbye, good luck. Best of luck to you in whatever you decide to do, whether it's college or going to work. And even though this school year didn't end the way we thought it would be, you're still graduating, you're still moving on with the next chapter of your life, okay?
Even though we weren't able to finish off the year as we had planned in the classroom, I really enjoyed teaching them. I enjoyed our discussions. I enjoyed our conversations. And it has been really one of the best senior groups that I have taught.
I had the great pleasure of having you as my class, and our time was not long enough, but I did get to know each and every one of you, and it made me feel very hopeful for the future because this class is full of integrity and strong beliefs and a wonderful work ethic and everything that you need to succeed in the world. I wish you love, I wish you faith, I wish you every good thing that you've ever hoped for and worked toward. Going forward, you will face challenges, but I know that you have the strength, wit, and wherewithal to meet those challenges head on.
Anyway, I just wanted to say that it has been an honor and a privilege to have you guys in my classroom. Many of you for 4 years. I will miss you more than words could ever say. And I love you all very, very much. I want you to go out there and conquer the world and fight for your dreams and do what you're supposed to do, what you want to do. I love you very much. Each and every one of you is going to take a piece of my heart with you when you go. But I know that you're going to be great.
You're graduating. Best of luck in your next adventure. From the bottom of my heart, I wish you guys lots of prosperity. And when all this is over, go ahead and celebrate. You deserve it. This is an amazing accomplishment and achievement.
I know this is bittersweet, and it's not at all what you guys have deserved. You guys have worked really hard to have a graduation, and you will currently have a virtual graduation, but in the near future, you will have the graduation you deserve. I've had the true pleasure of having you guys in my classroom this year, and I've gotten to know each and every one of you, some more than others because I've had you for a few years. That being said, I know that you guys will accomplish great things, and I wish you nothing but the best in the future. I hope that you will stay in touch, and you know how to reach me if you need me. Love you, and stay safe.
Bye. Good luck.
Good luck with everything, and good luck to everybody. Come back and visit. Bye.
And I wish them the best of luck, and I hope that I continue to hear from them and that they keep in touch.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You did it. I love you.
I wish you all the best. I send you love. I send you joy. And if you ever need me, you know where I am. Congratulations. Love you.